the war for talent really refers to the competitive landscape between attracting and retaining talent. I think originally the phrase was coined by McKinsey back in the early 90s. And even though the competition for talent is probably similar, how you're actually engaging and attracting and retaining talent is definitely different. There's probably two ways that I like to look at it. If you look at a strategy around the attraction piece, how you're engaging with certain talent communities, and then obviously the retention of talent within your business, how you keep key employees engaged.
For the first time, we're seeing a shift in real expectations around what an employer should be. 50% of Generation Zs are quoting purpose as the number one factor for what would influence them joining an employer. Now that actually feels alien to some of us who are operating at maybe the more Gen X sphere. And that's really critical too in terms of solving this war on talent. So thinking about the landscape within which you're operating in, and then examining that context, if you like, in terms of your own organisation, and increasingly because it's so challenging to simply, you know, procure somebody from the marketplace. It's so difficult. Organisations are having to be much more, I say innovative, but it's really inventive about how do we stand out and what is our unique proposition going to be? Because actually for so many sectors now, they're not really competing with themselves as a sector. We're seeing much more collapsing, if you like, of industry-led skills and demand being around digital and data fluency. So if you're sitting in, say, a bank or in a public sector company, you're actually now competing with talent against the big tech players in Ireland, who we know have really moved the bar in terms of compelling proposition.
I know we've heard the term culture eats strategy for breakfast. What is your take on how companies competing with the likes of Google or Facebook can attract talented candidates when they were up against these big players?
For financial services and certainly within DMS governance, what we have decided to do is to leverage some of the key initiatives that have Facebook's and your Google, what they have discovered in terms of attracting and retaining their candidates. The likes of flexibility around working hours is a huge hot topic at the moment. It's around looking at the person proposition as opposed to looking at their output. Because at the end of the day, it's the person that's coming to work. It's not just about what can this person achieve.